Good afternoon, Karen.
Good afternoon, David. Good to be here as always.
Yeah, you have a big smile on your face.
Every
Why
time.
is that?
Well, I made a comment on one of the posts in the Facebook group where someone was expressing how much they love the videos that we do.
Oh.
And for me, doing these videos is one of my favorite parts of my week, to just be able to share and express what I'm learning that's helped me so much in my life and in my marriage, and getting to share that with other women so that they can have hope and have a new way of experiencing themselves and their lives and in their relationship. And to me, that's just a really fun thing to do.
Okay, well, thank you. I enjoy these videos with you as well.
Yeah.
So, my name is David Cope, and I'm a founder of a new life center with my partner, Peggy Litt. And Peggy and I have been together almost 15 years. I started getting involved in relationships and teaching people how to find happiness in their relationship because I got a divorce in the year 2000 and I was crushed. And I w didn't want to be on my deathbed wishing I had had a loving and intimate relationship. So I spent some time reading books and trying to understand what is it that takes to a person to have, a man to have, a loving and intimate relationship with another woman. And what happened when I was reading the books is that I found out the books were telling me the same thing that I was trying to do in my marriage that never seemed to work. So I realized there had to be something else than what was in the books. And I came to this awareness is that in order to have a loving and intimate relationship with another woman, and I had to have a loving and intimate relationship with myself. And for the last 15 years, I've been teaching others and myself how to build a relationship with myself so that I can have a loving and intimate relationship with my partner, Peggy. And building a relationship with myself is the foundation of having intimacy with myself so that I can bring that to a relationship and not expect my partner, Peggy, to do the things that make me feel that our relationship is intimate. And it's a wonderful burden that has taken off my partner's responsibility, that she somehow is responsible for how I feel and the intimacy that's in our relationship. And that's my responsibility for my part. So, Karen, can you talk a little bit about you and your background?
Absolutely. So my name is Karen Seitz, and I'm the administrator for the Facebook group, as you probably have noticed. And I'm also the lead teacher for the relationship course that we offer at a new life center. And I came in to the program and learning these concepts and working on them, working on myself with them about 4 years ago. And I was at a place in my marriage, I was newlywed, and I thought that getting married would be my answer to happily ever after. And the honeymoon stage was very, very short-lived, and almost felt like it never even existed, because as soon as I got married, all of my issues and challenges really started to come to a head. And I blamed my husband and made it all about him, and he needed to change. He's the one that needs to work on himself, and was really headed towards a divorce. It wasn't working. And coming into the relationship course and the concepts that we teach at a new life center allowed me to start to build a relationship with myself, and it was almost like magic. But then my husband started to interact and respond to me differently as a result of me changing. And so now that's what I get to teach other women how to do every single day. And it brings a lot of joy to me and my life, and I'm very passionate about what we have to offer, and what we teach.
Can you share the foundational principles of our relationship course and our Facebook group for authentic intimacy for married women?
Of course, these are always just a really good reminder. they set the framework and can really help you to understand yourself in a new way, and also understand the ideas and things that we're teaching and presenting in the group. So the first principle is that you are responsible for your happiness, that there's no thing and no one that can make you happy, that happiness comes from the inside, and that we have to go within and find that within ourselves, and then we get to bring that out into our lives and into our relationships. The second principle is the only person you have any control over to change is yourself. You can't change your husband, and there's nothing your husband can do to change you, as much as we would love for that to happen. It doesn't work that way. So when I can understand that if I want a different experience of myself and my marriage or anywhere in my life, it all begins with me. And that empowers me to be in control of my experience and change, and then have a happy relationship and a happy marriage, because I have that with myself. And the third principle is that authentic intimacy is really having a relationship with yourself and feeling good about who you are. It's when you know who you are and you feel good about yourself that you can fully share yourself in your marriage and be who you really are with your husband. And that's what begins to create intimacy in a marriage and a relationship. It's not something you work on together. It starts with you, and then you bring that into your relationship.
Okay. Thank you, Karen. So for our listeners, just as a reminder that this Facebook group and our videos are for women, married women, or women in relationships, or actually women who want to learn how to have a healthy relationship.
Yeah.
And we do offer courses for men, and know that men have issues and they have things that they need to work on, just like women. However, over the years of our research and study, we have found that if a woman is with a good man, that she has all the power and control to create the foundation of the marriage, and in that power allows her to make the choice and decisions and changing herself in order to create the marriage that she wants. Because when she's with a good man will be there waiting for her and supporting her as she changes and creates the relationship that she's always wanted. We had a wonderful video of that, both from a man's perspective and a woman's perspective, and how when a woman changes with a good man, it changes the dynamics of the relationship into a healthy, loving relationship. Also, as you're listening, ladies, please try to see yourself in the concepts we're talking about. Each of these videos are things that you can do to change yourself that are accessible and easily recognizable if you open your heart and see yourself as the topics that we're talking about. Today we're talking about why married women stop having fun. And it's over the years that we've been doing the research and study, you can imagine if a woman gets married and she stops having fun, the intimacy in the relationship drops very quickly, because part of intimacy not only is a connection and feeling supported, but it's also feeling alive and engaged in the relationship. And if the funness, the spontaneity of the relationship disappears, then it's really difficult to create intimacy on a foundation when we lack the basic understanding of how and why to have fun. So over the years, in working with many women, we've learned why women stop having fun when they get married, so that you can be aware to make different choices and create fun in your life again, which adds a richness in your own life, so you can bring that into life. So Karen, I guess a good place to start is maybe if you can read some of the narratives and what women have said to themselves in the work that are shared with you and in the work about how they understand themselves as not having fun anymore and why that happens.
Yeah, I can. And it is something that comes up a lot with many of the women clients that I work with. And I also just want to stress again, this is all really normal. It doesn't make us, I say this many times in the video because I think it's important to understand, knowing this about yourself or seeing this in yourself is a good thing, because that gives you the opportunity to take a step forward and change. As long as we're pretending this isn't going on inside of us, and we don't want to look at it and we push it away, we can't change it and have a different experience of ourselves. So the point of looking at this and seeing this in yourself is so that you give yourself the chance to change. And that's what the work that I have to share from some of the women that I've worked with, that's what they gave themselves, a whole new experience and the ability to have fun by doing this work and seeing this. So the first thing, David, I think would be good to share was one of my clients did some work to find out what her internal dialogue or her internal narrative was with herself around having fun, so she could catch that and begin to work. And so as you, as our viewers listen to this, see if you can, like David said, see yourself in this or hear yourself in this. So this person's narrative or inner dialogue around having fun was, I never have fun. Fun is boring. I do not want to put in this much effort to have any fun. I'm not worth it. It is not exactly how I want it. I need it to be perfect, and so on. And she realized that in some way, this narrative or inner dialogue had been playing out in her entire life. And the result of that was no fun, and that she is miserable when she tries to have fun. And that's a really common experience that I see in many of the women that I work with, including places I've had to see in myself.
So Karen, as a way to help our listeners understand how we get to this place, women get to this place about where they stop having fun. You know, for us men, we seem to like to have fun no matter how old we get. And often women said, men never grow up. They're just grown-up kids. And we realizing that men and women are different. And one of the ways that men are different is that we never seem to grow up and stop having fun, though our women partners think that that's immature and they have a different perspective. So for women, why they get to this place and stop having fun is that we've talked a lot about how we put our walls up. And women put their walls up to protect their hearts. And when they get married and eventually what happens, their walls go up. Mm-hmm. And they slowly push their men away. And what happens is the women think in the relationship with a good man that it's the men that my husband stopped taking care of things. He doesn't do the things around the house. I can't be assured that he'll follow through with everything. And everything is my responsibility. And I'm exhausted. And it's like having my husband is like having another child in my house. I have to do everything in my house by myself, and my husband's not there for me. So the reason why that dialogue is so common is because when a woman has her walls up around her heart, she's pushing her husband away. And his response to the woman's walls is to eventually give up and stop trying, because he gets tired of having that reaction of the walls up and the coldness and distance and the controlling that creates. And so when women drop their walls, then the men can reengage in a healthy way. So the reason why women stop having fun is because they have their walls up and they're eventually trying to control their life. That what we've learned over the years with working so many with women, they define having fun as, I'm reading a list that I wrote down, it's exhausting. And they defined having fun as a loss of control, or it's frivolous, it's a waste of time. Fun is only for the young, or fun is irresponsible, or it's too much work and effort, or fun is immature. And eventually this dialogue goes on, and it's because they're slowly closing themselves down and controlling their lives in such a way that everything has to be managed and manipulated to create the life in their experience. And in that place, it begins to feel like there's no place for fun. That often I hear women say they become martyrs, that no, there's no time for fun. I have to do everything. The responsibility is on my shoulders, and my husband isn't there for me, and it's, I have no energy, and there's no place for fun. So what we're trying to do is give you a way to recreate the relationship and open yourself up to having fun and having an experience in life that's full and rich. And fun is an opportunity to be an expression of yourself. So when we ask men, what is fun to you? Men have a whole different perspective on fun, and they look at it, they're having a good time with themselves, or they're giving themselves the things that they need for themselves. So hopefully you can understand why over time, if you've stopped having fun or feeling like fun is too much work because you're drained, you can begin to understand why that might be happening in your marriage. Karen, can you share some of the other things that women have shared working with you about their perspective on fun? So maybe the women that are listening can hear themselves in this as well.
Of course. And I wanted to share, for me, when I look at myself in this, my definition of fun was a daunting task.
Oh.
I've got to take time out from all the things I have to do. And like David was saying, that kind of martyr perspective of like, oh, I've got too much for me. I can't do that. And for me, in the beginning of my relationship with my husband before we were married, and I know that many of our viewers can look back and see this too, I was a bundle of fun. I was open to doing anything my husband wanted to do. I was always on board. It was like I made sure that I was a fun person to be around and could have a fun time, because unconsciously I was looking to get that relationship and seal the deal, so to speak, so that I didn't have to be alone. And so when we got married and I finally got that piece, sealed the deal, like I said, then that's when I put my walls up, and now I've got to be the responsible one here. Yeah. I don't have time for fun, and that's where it really all began. And I just wanted to share that to, again, normalize this. And
can you share what you're talking about, your husband and being married? What did your husband say to you about having fun?
Yeah, as I started to work on myself and open myself up in my relationship, my husband began to feel safer to be honest with me and share his true experience of how me having my walls up and pushing him away affected him. And I asked him, well, what's it like being with me that I don't want to have fun and I'm no fun? What's that like for you? And he was very honest with me and said, well, I wait to have fun when you're not around, because I know it's going to be really hard to get you in that space to have fun. Mm-hmm. And it always feels so controlled that I really can have fun when you're not around. And yeah. That was really humbling and vulnerable for me to hear. And it seems counterintuitive, but those are the very kinds of things that then create intimacy.
Yeah.
He was able to share that with me in a place where I was open to hearing it and letting him in. And that allowed me to get really honest with myself and work on my relationship with myself of, okay, Karen, it's time to learn how to have fun again. And that had to start with me and me beginning to engage with myself and the things that I like to do to make me happy. And beginning to have fun again and recognizing, like David said, that is just an expression of myself. And it's a way to take care of me and be engaged in my life and feel alive. And when I'm able to do that with myself, then I get to bring that into my relationship with my husband. And I have to be honest, it's not always easy. Mm-hmm. It's not. As Peggy has said in some of our videos, it's a process.
Yeah.
So it's a commitment to myself to keep going and exploring the ways I've shut myself down to having fun, mm-hmm. and then re-engaging with myself to be able to do that again. And that's what I teach other women how to do. So I
Can
have
to. Yeah, thank you. I'm sorry to interrupt you. Can you share some of the dialogues that women have? Again, for our listeners, this one of the things that makes us different at a new life center and our relationship course is we've been doing research and study with women in relationships for over 10 years. And the information we're presenting you is 10 years of working with women, sharing their truths of their experience and compiling it so that we can work with other women and see the commonality that women have in relationships with good men so that you can make changes to see the things that you are in control of, that you can change within yourself to see if that will add to having a more intimate relationship with your husband.
So a lot of women, it's so relieving. It's like, oh, you mean other women experience this too?
Yeah.
Again, it just normalizes it. I'm like, yeah, of course. And then it doesn't seem like such a big deal, which is so important in being able to work on it. So without further ado, I do have some other work from a client that I worked with. I have a couple of other things to share. And this was someone's experience of themselves to fun. And they defined fun as irresponsible, mm-hmm. Which is a really common definition mm-hmm. that we give to having fun. So I am controlling, meaning fun has to look a certain way. I need to be the boss. I have to shut fun down. Others can't have fun if I'm not having fun. I have to be serious. Life doesn't work if I am not the responsible one.
Right.
If I am not the responsible one, no one else will be. I am hard. Meaning burdened by the weight of being miserable.
Wow.
Because the inverse experience of ourselves to having fun is being miserable on the inside.
Yeah. And we talked a lot about, Karen, that in another video, how some women don't want to be happy because it's fleeting and they can't be in control of happiness. But the one thing they can be in control is their unhappiness or how miserable they are. And that is what they can control. So it kind of goes hand in hand. Realizing in order to have a loving and intimate relationship with your husband, you have to be internally happy. And if you're not having fun and you feel like your life is a burden and your husband is boring and you have to be responsible for everything in your marriage, then what you begin to realize is that's just an expression of your inner unhappiness or miserableness. And I like to say often, imagine yourself as a happy person and you like to have fun. How would your marriage be different if you were happy and you woke up every morning engaged and in your life? And what the mind wants to say, of course, is, yeah, but you don't know my husband. I can't be happy. Well, yes, I know that somebody can't make me happy, but I sure know somebody can make me unhappy, and my husband is the source of my unhappiness. But that's, again, and we teach in our courses, that that's the foundation of being a victim and being powerless to change. And what we're trying to do is give women opportunity to see the things that they do have control over. We do have control over our own inner experience of our internal experience of our contentment and peace within ourselves, and realizing that if, as a woman, you feel happy and content in your life, then you would be happy and content in your marriage, regardless of the husband that you have, because you would see that you would find the things in your husband that you saw in him when you married him, when you fell in love with him. And that he's the same man, he hasn't changed, and he's the same man that you used to have fun with and go out and play and be kind of carefree and fun. that when you change how you feel about yourself, and that's what we teach in our relationship course, how to teach women how to have find happiness with themselves and bring that, then you see, you find all the happy things and wonderful things in your life. And just like when you're unhappy, you project onto your husband that he's the source of your unhappiness. And of course I hear, yeah, but you don't know my husband, he's different. But it really, men are pretty simple, and we respond very quickly to kindness and softness and caring, and where we can magically change overnight. If the woman we are with finds her happiness within herself, so that we as men don't have to carry the burden of the responsibility of making our wife happy, because as a good man, we want to, our wives to be happy, and we try to do everything we can. But eventually what happens, we stop trying, because there's nothing we can ultimately do to make a woman happy if she is unhappy inside. That's why we teach in this course is that you're the only one that can make you happy. And that's hopefully you can see that happy and fun kind of go together. And often, pardon for the language, but when you're unhappy, what happens, you tend to get a stick up your butt. We often say, women realize that everything is controlled and everything has to be a certain way. And women spend their life with their walls up, controlling their lives to manage their experience and control not only their experience, but their life. And that's part of why they begin to stop having fun, because they feel like everything in their life is their responsibility. And that if something doesn't get done, it's up to me and to the woman to get it done, because the man isn't there. And all of a sudden, life isn't fun anymore, and it becomes a burden and a responsibility.
Like I'm constantly trying to keep everything from falling apart, because yeah. That's how I always feel on the inside.
That's right.
I always feel like I'm about to fall apart. And yeah. Part of what David was sharing and how men respond to kindness and softness
and fun.
And fun, yeah. And having fun, I see this and my husband again and again and again. And the interview I did last week with McCall, one of my clients, she did a great job of expressing her experience of this. But, you know, sometimes in the morning I'll wake up and it's like right down to business, like no room to have fun. Got to get my day going. Don't try to make jokes. Don't try to be nice. It's serious time. And I can watch my husband just shrink away and feel pushed away by me, and can see it in him. In the mornings where I am open and happy within myself and sharing that with him, he lights up. Yeah. And it's fascinating to watch that and to see how much control and power I do really have as a woman with a good man to set the tone for my marriage. It's very tangible.
Thank you, Karen. You're working with a lot of women over the years and helping them in their relationship. One of the common things that often come up is how uncomfortable they are when they go to a friend's house and their husband starts having fun. And they see it as embarrassing and like, well, he drinks too much and I don't like it when he drinks too much. And he acts a certain way and I get embarrassed and I want to leave. And it's a very common experience for women to have when they see their husband having fun. They're embarrassed. And what the women begin to realize is that sometime in their life they stopped and they I don't want to be that woman anymore. I want to be a fun, engaging, alive person that can feel free to express myself and not be so rigid and controlled. And that's the value of a relationship course and working with women is to open their hearts up again, to build a relationship with themselves so they feel connected and they want to engage in life and they can start having fun can be described in lots of ways, but a woman that's embracing life and is filled with love and energy and light is and brings that out into the world. So it's a very common thing for women to get upset with their men. I don't like it when he drinks too much. And men, you know, we like to drink. We don't, most men in on average, you know, we like to drink enough, but we feel in control. And often women feel like if I can't drink, or I don't want to drink too much, because then I'll be out of control. And I don't like it when I'm out of control. So I make sure that I'm in control and being very careful. So it's obviously there's some balance in here, but we're hoping to see that there is a way to let go of the burdens of life and to gauge in yourself, so you can have the freedom to express yourself in a healthy and responsible way.
Yeah, it's like we tend to have little flirtations with our partners before we get married and put our walls up and stop having fun, and you know, little things my husband used to do just to kind of play and be flirty. I used to love and engage with, and then I slowly started watching myself close off to those things and kind of swat him away, even.
Yeah.
Stop. I've got to get this done. Stop. Yeah. and for a little while he keep trying to engage me, and then he stopped.
Yeah.
And he became really distant and checked out of the relationship. And that's what we're trying to teach, to see how much more power you realize you have to turn that around. It doesn't mean you aren't experiencing those behaviors in your husband. But what we're trying to teach you is that if you're with a good man and he's pulling away from you and he's distant or on the computer all the time and checked out, and he's a good man, that as the woman, you've put your walls up and pushed him away and stopped having fun. And that's what we want to empower you to see, is when you can recognize that and start to work on that and let your walls down, your husband will respond to that, and all those things you're seeing in him that you don't like, he's gonna change, because your experience of yourself has changed and you feel good about yourself, and you're bringing that into the marriage, and he's responding to that. So really what we're talking about here is empowering yourself to have the marriage that you always wanted by learning to drop your walls and re-engage and have fun again.
Yeah.
And it almost seems kind of silly when we stop to think about how we've stopped having fun and don't want to have fun. I don't have time for that
I have to get myself in the mood to have fun. That's one of the common things I hear from women all the time. I have to be in the right mood to have fun.
When you know yourself and you have a relationship and you've been doing the things you need to do to make yourself happy, it's just a natural expression of who you are.
Yeah.
Have fun, and you don't have to try. You just have to be yourself.
Yeah.
That's all.
It's in another way for a man understanding fun. It isn't you know going out and partying and dancing and all. That's not necessarily fun, but fun is more like a silliness, a playfulness, not taking everything so seriously and just kind of be playful and silly. And it's so endearing for a man when his wife can be silly and playful, like when we first started going out, just have a little fun.
Yeah, it's really all it takes. Yeah.
So, did you have anything else you wanted to share from other women, or do you think it's time for us to kind of wrap things up?
I think we shared a lot, and maybe we can. One of the other things that I had, maybe we can do a separate video on that. And that would be another angle of this.
Which is what?
Being rigid.
Oh, being rigid, yeah.
That's just another angle of standing.
And rigid, we work with a lot of women and them feeling rigid, meaning I have to control everything that's going on, and everything has to be manipulated in such a way that I know what's going to happen to me, and I know my experience. But that's rigid is the antithesis of fun, is carefree in a responsible way. We're not talking about being fun and being irresponsible. We're being grown-up adults and still liking to have a good time and be silly and playful.
So actually enjoying myself and
enjoying myself. My That's right. Yes.
Enjoy my husband and enjoy my marriage.
Yeah.
Instead of seeing it as this burden and weight that I have to carry around.
Yeah.
That's I've right. got the responsibility.
And my it's my husband that stopped having fun. He's boring and he's not interested in anything. Well, the reason why you think your husband is boring is because you have become boring. And you project that onto your husband. And of course, you see him laying around and you don't think he's engaged. But again, as women, when you have your walls up, over time, you push your husband, if he's a good man, away from you further and further. And eventually, he stops trying to do anything nice because he, no matter what he does, he can't do it right and he can't please you. And he gets tired of being criticized. And eventually, he turns into the roommate that you so much don't want to be with anymore. So we just hope that you can see that something about yourself can change is to try to let your walls down and have fun in a responsible way.
Thank you, David. All right. So do you want me to wrap up?
And, sure.
All right. So just anyone catching the tail end of this video today, we've just been talking about how it's really common and really normal for women once they get married, they stop having fun. It's almost like we forget how to have fun because we're so closed off and have so many walls up and we have to be in control. And if I don't do it, nobody's going to do it. I have to be responsible for everything. And what that does to a good man is that pushes him away because if there's something, and I see this in my husband, it's, there's just a natural go-to for him to go to having fun and enjoying life. And when I've got my walls up and I'm unhappy within myself, then I make him wrong for that and irresponsible and just push him away even further. So when we can see that in ourselves and see that we've stopped having fun and how that's affecting our relationship and our marriage, then we can start to re-engage with ourselves. And by re-engaging with myself and building a relationship with me and learning how to make myself happy and doing things for fun in my own personal life, mm-hmm. then I right. begin to open back up. And that's when you can see your husband's behavior completely change and he opens back up to you. Mm-hmm. And you take the lead and he will follow. And that's what we're talking about today. So if you're listening and realizing and knowing, oh yeah, I have stopped having fun.
Yeah.
It's real. I have to, like David said, I have to get myself in the mood to have fun and it's really hard and it feels like too much effort and you're hearing yourself in this, then reach out and private message me and we'll set up a free 1 hour breakthrough call where we get really clear on what's not working in your marriage, not the stories that you tell yourself, but getting really honest and having the guidance from me to help you peel back those layers to see what's really going on, which is invaluable. It will help you have a clear picture of where you need to go and the steps you need to take. And if it feels like you're a good fit for our program, then we can go there and talk about that. And if not, that's fine too. You will still get so much out of having this breakthrough session. So private message me if this is speaking to you and you want to re-engage and learn how to have fun again, I can help you. Our course can help you. And I would love to talk and get to know you more. So like I said, you can private message me and we'll get something set up.
Thank you, Karen, for sharing. It's always a joy and pleasure sharing this with you because I know that you're a true teacher doing this work in your marriage. And all of us at a New Life Center is very important that we're living the teachings that we're talking about and working hard within ourselves and know that marriage and relationship with others is a lifelong journey. And we continually have to look at ourselves to see how we can change and grow and meet our partners on their journey and share it together in a loving way. So thank you, Karen, and our listeners, and have a nice evening. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.